Imagine them being your children. They take this man and sell him back off into captivity, and they take your children and sell you off into captivity somewhere. Separate the family. Would you not cry for your children day and night, thinking about what could be happening to them? Would you not want to get back to your daughters knowing what's going to happen to them because of slavery?
Yeah.
I'm going to show you it's recorded in the Bible. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 32.
Yeah.
We come out here to show our people what our fathers could not teach us,
right,
what our mothers could not teach us,
right,
what our parents could not teach us,
right,
and what they're taking out of the schools so that these babies will never learn that they are the Israelites, God's chosen
right.
people. Why is this so important? What's the importance of us coming out here and trying to teach our people who we are according to this Bible? Because we have not learned. When I say Jaden, right? What's your nationality? What do you tell me? You tell me black. Well, look at your pop's pants. What color is his pants? Are you black? Look at his pants. Are you black? No, he's not black. If I ask the daughters, these your daughters? If I said, what's your nationality? What would you say? Black. If we don't say black, we would say African American. But that's not a nationality either.
Right.
This is why it's important for us to learn this. Watch this. Who is this? Who? Jesus? What do you say? Who is this? Jesus? But I guarantee you, y'all didn't teach them that this is Jesus. You see what's going on here, Jaden? I guarantee you, mother and father didn't teach them that. So who did?
Right.
Who did teach them that that is Jesus? Because is that what is recorded in the Bible? No, let's see what's recorded in the Bible. This is why the other nations do not want us to learn our nationality.
Right.
This is why they have a problem with Kanye saying that we're the real Jews and we're the Israelites. This is why they had a problem with Nick Cannon. This is why they're going to have a problem with any black man or woman that learns their true nationality and realize that you are not a nigga, you're not black, you're not African American.
Right.
Because the same man that we reverence and we know is going to come back and crack the sky to redeem a certain people, guess what color he is? He is black.
That's right.
Watch this. Read.
Wait, come on.
Revelation chapter 1, verse 14.
I want verse 1. Let's start at verse 1. What's the root word of revelation? What's the root word? The root word in revelation. The root word in revelation is reveal.
What?
Reveal. Revelation means to reveal. To reveal what? To reveal our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Right.
Now, we're not saying that this is Jesus Christ. The Bible explains and gives us a depiction of what Christ would look like if he walked the earth today.
Right.
Let's see if he looked like this. Read verse 14.
Revelation chapter 1, verse 14. His head and his hairs were white like wool.
Now let's do a process of elimination. It said his hair and his head and his hairs were white like wool. Like wool. So it's describing a color and a texture.
Right.
What color is the hair on this man's head that they've given us as a depiction of Jesus Christ? Is it white?
No.
Strike one, baby girl. Strike one. Now, is it woolly? Is his hair woolly? No. Strike two. So who on the earth has woolly hair? We know. That's wool on Jaden's head.
Right.
That's wool on your head, brothers and sisters. That's real wool. Those
right.
Afro pups right there? That's real wool right there.
That's
God-like hair right there.
Right.
God got hair like that. It says it was white in color and woolly in texture. You got a grandfather. I see you got a nice little beard, right? You got a grandfather. Your grandfather, if he lived a certain age, what color his beard turned? What color his hair turned? So Christ had white and woolly hair. That's the hair of Negroes. But now, here's the kicker. Watch this.
As white as snow.
The Bible said it was as white as snow. Come on.
And his eyes were...
God is describing Jesus Christ's eyes. His eyes were what?
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
Uh-huh.
And his feet...
Look at his feet. Come on.
Like unto fine brass.
Now, what color is brass, Jaden? What color is brass? Like brown, like a penny, right? Brown. It says his feet was like fine brass. Brass is brown.
Right.
Come on.
As if they burned in a furnace.
Now, if you take that brass that's brown already and you put fire to it and burn it, what color will it turn? Jaden.
Bring it up.
If it's already brown and you turn it and you put fire to it and burn it, what color does it turn? It gets darker. How dark? Black.
Black.
Anything you burn turns what? If you burn rice, what color does it turn? If you burn a piece of paper, what color does it turn? So the Bible is saying that Jesus Christ was what color? Black. So what?
That's right.
Who the hell is this?
Jesus.
Who the hell is this guy?
Wake him up.
No, that ain't Jesus. So what his name is Cesare Borgia.
Right.
He's a real person that walked the earth. His name is Cesare Borgia. You can look into the history of the Borgias. What he did was he posed for Michelangelo during the Dark Ages and became the Renaissance picture for Jesus Christ.
Right.
He posed as Jesus Christ during the Dark Ages when we ruled and they gave him the life of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Wake him up.
Now they're pushing this gospel all around the world. So I'm going to show you how your children learn that this is Jesus Christ. When grandmother and grandfather ever took them to church? Took them to church before? When you walk into the church, what's normally in the church? A picture of who? What color is it? He's that color right there. Sitting up on the wall with his fingers like this.
Right.
That ain't Jesus.
Right.
That is the what they have done. Give me that in Sirach. I want Sirach chapter 3, verse 48. What they've done, they know that you're the chosen people. They know that we are the chosen people. So imagine this. If your sons and daughters, these your kids, right? If I came into your house, boom, kicked your door in, your son too, I'm talking to y'all, we family. If I came into your house, kicked the door in, boom, kidnapped you and your son, drug you from your house to my house, separated you, I whoop you, I beat you, I rape your wife, I all of this in front of your kids. What do you think your mindset is going to be for them kids? To protect them. I can't continue to let this happen to us. This is what has happened. Somebody has come to our house, kicked the door in, took the fathers and the mothers, brought them to another land, and retaught them what is supposed to be their history. So now we've learned that this is what Jesus Christ looked like. Why? Because in slavery, this is the image that was given to us. Grandmama learned it. Her mama learned it.
Right.
Her mama learned it.
Right.
And everybody that learned it, guess what they did? They passed it on down to us.
Right.
Because it was a crime to read the Bible during slavery.
Right.
Now you're about to find out why. Watch this. I want y'all to listen. All of this is written. But what happens is, and what has happened, our pastors don't teach us what's in the book.
Right.
We go into church. They give us a shuck and a jive. We clap our hands, dance, thump our feet, walk out the door. And we ain't learned nothing about the history of the people in the book. We've learned nothing about why we're at the bottom of society
right.
and in the condition that we're in.
Right.
It's because we have yet to explore the experience of our forefather in this book.
Shalom, Israel. This is Bishop Nathaniel. I want you to know that you can view all our Sabbath classes live on IUIC TV. That's right. I said on IUIC TV. Download the app today. Shalom.
My familia is the 12.
Watch what they did. Read this.
First Maccabees chapter 3, verse 48.
Come on,
and laid open the book of the law.
It says, they laid open the book of the law. Who is the they? The they is our enemies, our oppressors. The ones that did this to the so-called Indians, and the ones that did this, lift that up, to the so-called African-American, Hispanic, Native American man in America today. The people that did this, they did what?
And laid open the book of the law.
The law is this Bible. Come on.
Wherein the heathen
are the other nations. Now today we go by a heathen name. You know what that name is? We go by as it that makes us a reference to heathen. American.
Right.
That's a heathen name. Like our forefathers during the Greek times, they had to call themselves Greeks. They couldn't call themselves Israelites. I'm gonna show you that in the Bible. They couldn't call themselves Israelites. They were forced to call themselves Greek.
Right.
To follow the Greek customs because they were under the oppression and captivity of the Greek Empire. Yes. All right? It says that they laid open a book of the law wherein the heathen
had sought to paint the likeness of their images.
Uh-huh. So they sought to paint the likeness of their images, meaning they looked at the history of our forefather, of our brother, of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And they said, hold on, we can't let him be black. We must paint him to match our complexion.
Right.
Thus, you have that movie, The Passion of Christ.
Right.
Y'all seen that movie? It made you cry, didn't it? Tell the truth, sis. I know, come on now. It made you cry. I know people that was in the movie theater. Oh my God, my God, my God. Thinking that's their Lord and Savior. That was done purposely. That's why our babies think that's Jesus Christ. You ever seen the movie 12 Years a Slave? When they took the sister's children from her and put, what was his name? The brother, Solomon. They put Solomon was a free man. They took him and put him back in slavery. They took the children of the woman. Imagine them being your children. They take this man and sell him back off into captivity. And they take your children and sell you off into captivity somewhere. Separate the family. Would you not cry for your children day and night? Thinking about what could be happening to them? Would you not want to get back to your daughters knowing what's going to happen to them because of slavery?
Yeah.
I'm going to show you it's recorded in the Bible. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 32.
Yeah.
We come out here to show our people what our fathers could not teach us,
right.
What our mothers could not teach us,
right.
What our parents could not teach us,
right.
And what they're taking out of the schools so that these babies will never learn that they are the Israelites, God's chosen
right.
people.
All right.
These are real princesses walking the earth. You are real God
right.
walking the earth.
That's right.
And they never want you to tap into that.
Right.
Watch this, read.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 32.
Yeah.
Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
Hold the post up, soldier. Hold the post up. It says your sons and your daughters are going to be given to another people. What's happening right here? What's happening is the children of Israel are being given an instruction from the creator of heaven and earth.
Right.
We were given instructions to keep the commandments of God on the earth.
Right.
God says, if you don't listen to what I'm telling you to do and rule this earth, like I'm telling you to go run it, your sons and your daughters shall be given into the hands of another people. And what else?
And thine eyes.
You're going to look with your eyes. You're going to be able to see your children being taken away from you. Read it again.
And thine eyes uh-huh. shall look and fail with longing for them all the day long.
It says your eyes are going to look and fail with longing for your children all the day long. Watch this.
And there shall be no might in thine hand.
And there ain't going to be no power in your hand to get your children back.
Right.
What is that called? It's called slavery.
Yes.
It's called slavery. The same information that they're taking out of the schools. These children will never study their true history in school. They'll never learn that they are the Israelites. They'll never learn what their forefathers and mothers had to suffer through in order for us to be able to walk amongst these people today.
Right.
Freely. They'll never learn that.
Right.
And it's purposely being taken out so that it keeps us as a nation docile, weak, and on the bottom of society.
Right.
Because the minute that you start keeping God's commandments, the minute that you start training and teaching your house to deal within the commandments of God and everybody change, and we all change to doing this, what God says, guess what's going to happen? Their kingdom goes down.
Right.
Yes.
Being on the bottom ceases to exist.
Right.
God, give me Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 6. Put that down. God says he made you different, like the brother was going into. He said he made you different than all people on the earth.
Right.
You're not like everybody else.
Right.
These baby girls are not like other women on the earth.
That's right.
They're different.
Right.
They're special to God.
Right.
But they have to learn and be taught how to walk according to what God has called them to be, which is a real princess. You watch little princess movies. I'm sure that they've seen some, right? You ever seen the princesses, how they're treated on those movies? They're treated with royalty.
Right.
Our women feet, your feet, see how you on the ground right now? You like walking? When we ruled, our women feet never touched the ground.
Right.
Our women feet did not touch the ground.
Right.
You had these same nations that have oppressed you, carrying you around.
Right.
When we ruled the earth. Tell me you don't want that back. Tell me you don't want that for your wife. Tell me you don't want that for your daughters.
Right.
There's something you gotta do, brother. If you want that, guess what? We are living in the last days. Come on up, brother. We're talking about how to regain rulership on the earth. What does it take for us to come off of the bottom? Section 8, trapping, smoking. What does it take for us to reunite as the people of God under the banner of the Bible? What does it take? Read this.
Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6. But thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
The Bible says, and he's only talking to the Israelites. These people on this sign right here. This is the only people that he's talking to. When you look on the back of your flyer, flip it up on the back. It has the 12 tribes of Israel listed right there. I'm pretty sure, brother, you are from the tribe of Judah. When you look on that flyer, it says Judah, then it says American blacks. Where do you fall at on that sign right there? You fall under Judah.
What?
You know what that means? You come from the same tribe that Christ himself come from.
That's right.
That's where you come from. Now, how do we know that? Can we prove that the blacks in America today are the Israelites from the tribe of Judah? Yes, we can prove all things with the Bible. But read Deuteronomy 7 and 6 again. Read that again.
Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God hath chosen thee.
The Bible is saying that the Lord God has chosen you, sister. Baby girl, mama, pops. The Lord thy God has chosen us. So why hasn't anybody told us this? We think all we got to do is go into church and say, I accept Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. And that's it. We saved. Is that what makes you safe? Are you saved? No. That is philosophy and doctrine that's been pushed in our community for years. You are not saved. Ain't none of us saved. Right. Grandmama ain't saved. Granddaddy ain't saved. Ain't none of us saved. And we know this Bible from the front cover to the last page. From the front page to the last page. With understanding. We are not saved yet.
Right.
When will we be saved? When that sky crack open and our Lord and Savior return to redeem the children of Israel as it is written. It's going to happen.
Yes.
We just...
Nation is men leading by example. Nation is family. Nation is community. Nation is children with role models. Nation is you.
And finally, my brethren, be strong enough.